Watch, Texas agent killed at Mexico border, so Trump halts cabinet meeting to unleash hell. Over the weekend, two brave Border Patrol agents stationed along the porous border between Texas and Mexico were ambushed by a group of illegal immigrants who bashed them in the head with blunt objects. One of the agents, Rogelio Martinez, was killed on the scene, while the other agent was critically injured. Then, on Monday, President Donald Trump halted his cabinet meeting in order to unleash hell on the suspects who attacked the Border Patrol agents and those on the left who essentially allowed the assault to take place thanks to their support for open borders. On Sunday, a pair of Border Patrol agents were attacked while on duty in Texas. One did not escape with his life. The other agent, who was injured, was immediately sent to a local hospital where he remains in serious condition. A U.S. Border Patrol agent died this morning as a result of injuries sustained while on patrol in the Big Bend sector, U.S. Customs and Border Protection said in a statement. Agent Rogelio Martinez and his Big Bend sector partner were responding to activity while on patrol near Interstate 10, in the Van Horn Station area, the statement added. Agent Martinez's partner reported that they were both injured and in need of assistance, the statement continued. Responding agents provided immediate medical care, and transported both agents to a local hospital. Big Bend sector was later told that Agent Martinez expired from his injuries. His partner remains in the local hospital in serious condition. Brandon Judd, the president of the National Border Patrol Council, NBPC, told the media, "We don't know exactly what happened because we weren't there. However, just from agents that were working in the area, reports are saying it was an attack and it would appear to be an ambush." President Donald Trump was furious when he heard about the tragic incident, as he has been pushing Congress to approve an impenetrable border wall for months now. At Monday's cabinet meeting, Trump paused to recognize the two brave men involved in the ambush. Glancing up from his notes, Trump said, "As you heard, we lost a Border Patrol officer just yesterday, and another one was brutally beaten, and badly hurt." The president added, "We talk about the wall. We're going to have the wall. It's part of what we're doing. We need it." Indeed, America needs the border wall now more than ever. Lives literally depend on it. Americans voted for Trump because they know that the wall is a necessary component in making our country safe again. Without the wall, criminals will continue to pour into our country and harm our law-abiding citizens. Trump ended his cabinet meeting on Monday with a heartfelt message to the two Border Patrol agents' families, saying, "My respect to the families that were so badly hurt yesterday. Because they were devastated, those two families were devastated." Devastated is a good way to describe the shock of learning that your loved one will not return home ever again after leaving for work one morning. That is if words could adequately describe something so horrific. The bleeding-heart liberals who champion open borders as a means to help illegal immigrants must realize that they are hurting American citizens in the process. Quite literally, they have blood on their hands, the blood of Rogelio Martinez, a legal U.S. citizen who gave his life in service to our country. Please keep the families of these men in your prayers this week. And keep pushing to build the wall along our border with Mexico, which will keep dangerous illegal immigrants out.